I can't work because I need that internet service. Is that a week, a month, a year? I don't know.
The power is back on for most of us, but now a lot of our viewers are struggling to get internet or cable. Some Comcast and CenturyLink customers say they haven't had a signal since Ian knocked them out. NBC2's Christy Soto is talking to people and businesses struggling to work without the internet.
Peter, we spoke to people here in the Cape and businesses like this pharmacy that are frustrated with Comcast and CenturyLink because they depend on the internet. And since COVID, a lot of people work from home too.
All this cable right here was inside my house, and there's like 30 feet of it that got ripped out.
Jay Lace's line, his lifeline to the World Wide Web, ripped from his home thanks to Hurricane Ian.
This is actually the CenturyLink fiber optic cable that connects to the pole across the street. So that's completely severed.
Service severed. Lace is one of the 19,000 CenturyLink customers offline.
I can't work because I need that internet service.
Many of you, like Lace, work from home, which makes the internet a necessity.
I currently work for a defense contractor, so I need very high security standards to be able to access their computer systems.
So public hotspots are not an option for Lease. He says it's slow and not safe.
I need some kind of ETA, and I need to know when I'm gonna have the service back. Is that a week, a month, a year? I don't know.
Businesses like TRX Pharmacy are feeling the frustration too.
We're just crippled right now. So if we don't have our computers, we can't operate.
Meaning they can't fill all prescriptions for people in need.
What we're kind of doing to help our current patients and clientele is just doing emergency fills.
Giving patients a three-day supply, but they can't make any insurance claims.
Unfortunately, insulin's very pricey, so and I can't just keep on handing out vials hoping I get paid retroactively.
Now the pharmacy is relying on this T-Mobile modem to do their job.
It's right now enough to run bare minimum tasks on our pharmacy software. It's better than nothing.
So here's the thing, as Comcast and CenturyLink work to restore your internet, many of you are using those T-Mobile modems, hotspots, or your phone to get internet access. And that internet comes from a cellular tower. And we actually use internet from a cellular tower in our live trucks here. So we ran a speed test, and mind you, we are in Cape Coral, and right now it's coming up to 0.05 megabits per second. That is extremely slow. A decent speed is anywhere between 10 and 20. Peter?
Christy, did you get a timeline from Comcast or CenturyLink on when that internet would be restored?
Yeah, so CenturyLink says that they expect to restore some services by the end of this week, but they weren't specific on what areas they're talking about to have that internet restored. As far as Comcast, I sent them emails. I didn't hear back, but they did update their website saying that all Xfinity stores across Southwest Florida are open now and ready to help customers. Reporting live in Cape Coral, Christy Soto, NBC2.